Hey there, Reveal TV community. Today, we're going to go back to basics and produce a quick video to show up the foundational understanding on the planning engine in ERP called MRP. Now, we have loads of videos around MRP, but this one is for those of you who are not really using MRP today and want a little level set. First of all, I want to clear up confusion around the acronym. MRP stands for Materials Requirements Planning. Second of all, we commonly hear organizations say that they don't run MRP. Most of the time, this is not true. MRP is merely running along in the background. You've just never had the opportunity to find the value in the results. This is an epic journey filled with value, and today we're going to start with some inspiration. It is in my opinion that there is no better human in this world to get you excited about MRP than my friend Sean. He has helped dozens of organizations come to grips with the journey and quality of MRP and has seen the outcomes for the business and for the people time and time again. So Sean, please tell us more about the definition and the purpose of MRP.
Like many things we encounter in life, getting MRP up and running and delivering great value can be challenging. However, at the core, it's very simple. MRP's purpose is life to the supply, the demand, and it does so by determining what is needed, how many are needed, and by when they are needed to be there. It's time and quantity. It's primary school math at scale running on a set of rules, which are discussed in some of our other videos. It's a plan for every part in each location. Now then, let's go and we take a look.
Well, welcome to the demo on what is the purpose of MRP. Now, in his introduction, Martin addressed MRP as an acronym and acknowledged that MRP stands for Material Requirements Planning. This is important because it is a good descriptor of what MRP does. However, what we want to do this morning is to use a transaction called MD06, and we are going to look inside of a plant at what does the MRP list look like in terms of the last run when MRP ran. And we'll take a look at that out there, and you can see here, there is a date at which the last MRP ran, which tells us this is the last time that MRP went to work to produce a plan for a production. Now, we already know that MRP is responsible for determining what materials need replenishment, how many, and by what date. And that's all according to the rules that we've set. Now, most organizations run MRP on a regular cadence. And so even if you don't trigger it yourself, it's out there juicing replenishment plans and managing the balance of supply and demand. It's a really, really good communicator.